Hello, this is Megha Pandre, and today we will start with a new chapter with lesson number 4, Supreme Court. And in this chapter, we will discuss why do we require law, what is the role of judiciary system, and which are the structures of the judiciary system. What is the role of the Supreme Court? And there is one example. With one example, we will come to know what is the importance of this structure, judiciary structure. And can any citizen appeal in a court? Okay, so here we will start with the explanation of this chapter called lesson number 4, Supreme Court. Now, why do we require law? Here we will continue with the both reading and the explanation part together. So here we will start with law. What is law? Why do we require law? Law is required for the safety and the welfare of the people. Laws are rules that bind all the people living in a community, and laws protect our general safety and ensures our right as citizen against abuses by other people, by organization, and by the government itself. So when any citizen or institution breaks any law, a specific process is followed to address the issue. The hierarchy of court to impart justice in a country. It starts with the Taluka court at the lowest, as the lowest court, succeeded by the district court and then the high court. And last comes the Supreme Court to the topmost. The judiciary is one of the most important organization of the government. Why it is one of the most important organization of the government? Because judiciary is independent from the legislature and the executives. Now, who are these legislature? Legislatures are the members of the legislative, and these are the people authority to make the law. And executive, who are those executives? Executives are the one who enforce the law. Now, here we will talk about what is the role of the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court is the highest among all the court in the nation. So it is one of the highest court in the nation. It came into existence on 28 Jan 1950. It holds a right of conferring the fundamental rights. Conferring means consult. It holds a right of consulting the fundamental rights granted to us by the Constitution. Citizens have the right to file an appeal directly in the Supreme Court if any of his fundamental right have been violated. So here, any citizen can file directly in the Supreme Court if he or she feels that his fundamental rights are being violated. Any citizen or institution can file a petition in the Supreme Court to avail justice in the view of the public interest. And this is known as PIL. PIL means public interest litigation. Now, what is public interest litigation? Public interest litigation, in simple word, means litigation filed in a court of law for the protection of public interest, such as pollution, terrorism, road safety, or constructional hazard. So these come under the public interest litigation. The Supreme Court interprets the Constitution and advises the President and the Parliament in the same regard. So here the Supreme Court has the right to interpret the Constitution, the rules and regulations which are being implemented in the Constitution. It also enjoys the power to review the judgment passed by any of the lower court. And here also he has the power to review whatever the judgment which is given in the lower court, district court or high court, whatever. The Supreme Court solves disputes between citizen and government and between states. Sometimes if there is a dispute between two states, then the Supreme Court has the power to resolve it. And sometimes the center and the state. So here, any of the disputes which is related with the state, the Supreme Court has the power to solve it. To understand this, let us study the Save Narmada movement of Gujarat. So this is one of the example we will take, where what was the role of the Supreme Court to solve the disputes of the people with the government. Now, to understand this, let us study Save Narmada movement of Gujarat. There was a project against increasing the height of Narmada Dam above 110 meters near Nawagam. Environmentalist organization and NGOs from Madhya Pradesh and other regions were fighting for the right of the tribes who would lose their land and habitat forever due to this project. As the height of this dam will increase, obviously then the nearby villages will automatically get submerged into the water. So they have to leave their places, their habitats forever. And for that reason, the tribes and the locals were fighting against the government. In this matter, the Supreme Court passed a judgment on 8th March 2006 to resolve this conflict between the two states. It stated that in accordance with the rising population, it was necessary to carry out this project as it is necessary to increase the height of the dam. Why? Because of the increasing population. There was a possibility of a positive development in the environment and benefit to all the living beings due to the Sardar Sarovar Yojana. And if you will compare the advantages of it, the advantages was more to the people. The arid region of Rajasthan and Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh would get water, and the expansion of the desert could be kept under control. So here, if the height of these dam will increase, obviously it will fulfill the need of the water. Proper rehabilitation of the tribals affected by this project should be given the top priority, and hence their fundamental rights could be protected. And those villagers, those tribal people who are living nearby the path of the river, they were shifted to a nearby place where their fundamental rights were also being protected. So this was one of the example of the Sardar Sarovar Dam. So here I end up with the explanation of this chapter. We will meet in the next video. Till then, goodbye.